NBC 5 News at 6 starts now.
Tonight, Canadians can drive across the border again into the U.S. Thanks for joining us tonight at 6 o'clock. I'm Brian Collarin.
And I'm Alice Kang. NBC 5's Elena Barilla is live at the Champlain Crossing tonight with more from travelers and border officials on today's milestone. Elena.
Well, it's a much quieter scene now than it was early this morning. Many Canadians waking up in the early morning hours to make the trip south for the first time in 20 months. RVs and cars lined up. These are the Canadians who plan to be the first to cross the border.
We're going to see our daughter. That was the last 2 years we didn't see her, and our granddaughter.
Some, like these two friends.
I think everybody was happy to go south.
Waited hours and took a rest stop in Plattsburgh.
There was only two gates open, so it took me 6 hours and 7 minutes to wait for the border.
This is my summer area, my playground since 1967.
Back in the North Country for the first time in almost 2 years. This snowbird and his pup also among the first to cross.
Took 1 hour and 32 minutes to cross the border. That's all. So that was okay. Not more than a regular 4th of July or Canada Day, 1st of July. That's about it.
The crossing, a much different scene Monday afternoon. Canadians are required to show proof of vaccination and are required to test before heading back into Canada.
It is worthwhile. For a weekend, well, that would be a no-no.
The North Country Chamber of Commerce believes that requirement will put a hold up on day and weekend trips.
That's costly. So really right now, while the border is open, the Chamber's real initiative is to continue to talk to our counterparts in Canada. How do we loosen this restriction? How can we make this go away? What are the steps we need to take?
They believe the most immediate impacts will be for business travelers, snowbirds, and families reuniting. Hospitality and tourism businesses will be especially welcoming of their arrival.
I can't tell you how much this border opening affects every facet of our economy.
You may notice some local businesses have signage outside for Canadians saying, "Welcome back, we've missed you." Live in Champlain, Elena Barilla, NBC 5 News.